How do I make my C drive not dirty? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Let's get right to the question. How do I make the C drive not dirty? I'm told my drive is dirty, and that this is because my laptop battery always gets drained, so the system was not shut down properly. I tried running CHKDSK, but it displays an error that it can't access my drive and that I need to do a system restore. But when I tried to do a system restore, I can't because it says something is wrong with my C drive. Is there another way to fix this? So, dirty, it's not a term you hear very often anymore. It's one of those terms that has been around for decades. What it really boils down to is simply that the operating system did not have a chance to write all of the information to the disk before power was removed. So very much in a case where you've removed the power suddenly without having the opportunity to shut down the system properly, the drive may be marked as quote unquote dirty. The solution is in fact CHKDSK. Now I'm really, really confused by any reference to system restore in this scenario. System restore, besides the fact that I really, really, really don't like system restore, you should never rely on system restore. System restore would actually have nothing to do with this scenario. So what I want to show you real quick here in Windows 11 is exactly what that error message you may have seen from CHKDSK would look like and what to do. So in Windows 11, I am going to right-click on the Start button and run an admin version of Windows Terminal. This could be Windows Command Prompt, it could be PowerShell, doesn't really matter, any of them will work. And I'm going to run CHKDSK/F, which is the fix option, which is in fact how one would fix a quote-unquote dirty disk. Now, in this case, it can't. And the reason it can't is because the disk is in use. There's no reference to system restore, maybe referencing system restart? I don't know. The bottom line is that because Windows is running, the disk is in use. So CHKDSK can't actually run. But what we can do is we can say yes, so that the next time we reboot the system, which I'll do right now, the next time the system is rebooted, it's going to run CHKDSK. So here you can see that Windows is in fact running CHKDSK before Windows itself is actually loaded. To say it's Windows running it is kind of a misnomer because Windows itself has not been loaded yet. But what has happened is that CHKDSK left instructions that the boot process paid attention to that said, okay, before you finish loading Windows, before you load Windows, let's run CHKDSK on the drive while the drive itself is not in use. That's what's happening right now. Once CHKDSK has completed, then Windows will boot up normally. And we're back. So how do we avoid a dirty disk? How do we avoid having to run into this situation? Well, it's actually very simple. Shut down your computer normally using the Start menu, like I just did when I restarted. In order to avoid these kinds of situations, the right thing to do is, of course, to shut down the system by using the Start menu to start the process of shutting down. That's because the process of shutting down includes making sure that everything is written properly to disk. If the power is suddenly removed, for example, your laptop battery suddenly runs out of power, or your main power to your desktop suddenly shuts off, that can result in this. And the worst case scenario, of course, is that this can in fact corrupt the drive to the point where the information on the drive is no longer accessible. It's rare, but it can happen. The bottom line here is that you just don't want to remove power suddenly from a machine. In the case of a laptop, that means don't let it run until the battery runs out. Make sure you're either plugging into power before that happens, or you're shutting it down manually before you run out of power. In the case of a desktop, if you're in an area that has sudden power outages or power flickers, those kinds of things, maybe invest in an uninterruptible power supply, a UPS. That's another way to make sure that not that your machine will run forever when the power is out, but that you'll have enough time to shut the machine down properly and avoid this problem completely. Hope that helps. For comments, for updates, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/149365. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.